Hi, I'm Alina from Superlina, and today we will be cooking one of my absolutely favorite immune-boosting soups. I call it, I can't believe it's butternut. It's butternut and red lentils and ginger and tomato, and it's amazing for you, for your immune system, for your bone health, for comfort, for love. Let's get started, you guys.
First, I start by chopping my butternut. This one is about 2 pounds. When you get to the seeds, I like to scrape them out and save them for later. I'll tell you why in a moment. Cube the squash into medium pieces like this, so they roast quicker and get some great color. I take out my baking sheet, I line it with parchment paper. I spread out my cut up butternut so none of the pieces are touching. Make a little space in the corner for the seeds. We're gonna roast them too. Then lightly drizzle the butternut with olive oil, but not the seeds. Season the butternut and the seeds with a little salt and red pepper flakes, and this will get them juicy and caramelized in the oven. Roast the butternut in the oven at 375 degrees Fahrenheit for 20 to 25 minutes. While the butternut is in the oven roasting, let's get our other ingredients ready. First, dice the onion. Then dice your tomatoes. Get your grater ready. Take a spoon and scrape the skin of the ginger, revealing the yellow flesh. Take your 1.5 inch of ginger and grate. Now all your ingredients are prepped. We can really get started on the soup. Take a large pot and coat the bottom with olive oil. Once the oil is heated, add the onions and let them cook down for a few minutes until they're translucent. Add a tiny pinch of salt to flavor the onions. Add the ginger, stir, and then add the tomatoes and saute them for about 2 minutes. Then add about 1/2 cup of filtered water to the pot. This is going to allow the onions, ginger, and tomatoes to cook together and combine their flavors. This is also going to get the tomatoes to release their lycopene. Lycopene is an antioxidant in tomatoes that help prevent cell damage and will keep your immune system strong.
And now that our onion, ginger, and tomatoes are in the pot and cooking, we're gonna wait for the butternut to come out of the oven nice and roasty.
Now that the butternut is done, we want to make sure that it's fork tender. Like this. That means it's ready to be put in the pot. Your seeds should be done too. The seeds work great as garnishes. I love to dress my soups with them. I eat them also in salads. Sometimes I just eat them plain. They contain lots of magnesium, iron, and calcium, and a great source of plant-based protein. Now we're going to add the butternut into the pot, and then we're going to add filtered water to make sure that it's covering all the butternut. Now we're going to cook it on medium-low. Make sure it doesn't boil. What you're looking for are little bubbles. Then add 1 cup of red lentils and let that cook. We want those to simmer over medium-low heat for 30 minutes to an hour. They will absorb lots of water. They will triple in size like this and become very soft. Once they look like this, turn off the heat and let the pot cool down for about 30 minutes.
And now that the soup is ready, we're going to blend it.
Ladle the soup into your blender or food processor and blend until silky smooth. Continue the process until you have all of your ingredients and all of the soup blended. Season your soup to taste and stir. And it's done! So now pour it into your favorite bowl, dress it with your roasted butternut seeds, and enjoy.
Okay, I'm gonna taste it right now. Turned out really good this time. Thank you for joining me, Superlina, in my very own kitchen. I will be back with more soups, more recipes, more videos, not just soups, but other healing foods. See you soon, soupies. Superlina tip number one. If after you blend your soup, it is too thick, just add some water. Just make sure the water was pre-boiled before, but you can thin out your soup to the desired consistency. Superlina tip number two. I forgot, you guys. So one really important thing is when you reheat your soup, make sure you don't use the microwave. I just don't like microwave. But if you have to, you have to. One thing that I love to do is put it in a little pot on the stove and make sure you don't boil it. Use low medium heat and just simmer it. And let me know how it goes. Share your comments below. I wanna know.